I didn't ask you this, but I talked to a lot of people who fought Manny before the Thurman fight, and everyone who fought Manny except Cotto, and I'm talking about 8 different people, picked Manny to beat Thurman. What did you think before, and what did you think after?
I told you, I said I picked Manny to win because I thought that Manny threw punches and bunches. It would be hard for Thurman to throw one punch at a time, But I was actually surprised by Keith Thurman. I thought he did an excellent job, and I told him in the locker room, I took my hat off to him, because he fought like a champion. He felt like he wanted to keep his belt, and he wasn't afraid of Pacquiao, and he fought. And I'm proud of him, man. I think he did a great job.
Who should Manny fight next? What do you want to see? Do you want to see Lomachenko? Do you want to see Crawford, Mikey, Danny Garcia, Mayweather rematch? Shane Mosley rematch.
I'm done.
What do you think? What's a good fight?
I will see the Mayweather rematch.
You do?
But
that would be good. You know what? Because it's an
event. You know what I'm saying? Like not just saying for the boxing, but it's an event. It's a world event. I think everybody still gonna want to see it. Pacquiao just fucking pulled off, you know, this a big win with Keith Thurman. So I think it's gonna be a world event. Like, a lot of people don't want to see them.
And they fight for the world title, and they both can retire themselves. They both can just say, you know what? We're just gonna get in the ring. We're gonna do another rematch, and this is the last one. We're gonna both retire. And that's
make
it.
More money.
Last
our grandkids.
That's it. And then you know, let the younger generation do their thing. You know what I'm saying?
Shane, you fought everyone on the planet in your era. Is there anyone that you wanted a rematch with, you never got a rematch, that you would have loved to have?
Oh, I would love to have a rematch with Mayweather, but...
That's the one fight.
Yeah, Mayweather, but because I did rematch with everybody, gave everybody rematches, and they gave me, like, Winky, Vernon, Oscar, Fernando Vargas won a rematch, they gave him one. You know, so it's like almost everybody I fought that, you know, that were champions that I gave rematches to, just because, and I didn't have to. But the only rematch that would probably be good, actually both Manny and Floyd, actually, to tell you the truth. Because both guys, you know, I don't think I was 100%, but, you know, it is what it is. It's boxing, you know what I'm saying? But I would love to see a rematch between Manny Pacquiao and Floyd, and because they're both the same age, you know, and Manny Pacquiao is a world champion, and... They can fight for the belt, you know? They can fight for it all. They're rated on box work as 1 and 2. So 1 and 2 need to go ahead and get it on and see what's going on.
It's crazy. Mayweather's fought 26 champions, and he beat 26 champs. But you're one of the few people to land a clean shot on him. No one's been able to do that, Shane. You remember that punch?
I didn't remember the punch. I was out at that time and shit like that. And... I picked Shane to fucking win. I was like, Shane got him. I was like, Shane got that motherfucker. The fucking whole bowl was going crazy and shit like that. And fucking Floyd, he just showed how.
How were you able to catch him when nobody else has been able to do that?
Well, because, you know, I'm more of an old school fighter, so I kind of slid in on him where he wasn't expecting me. I think that he was expecting to be able to roll and throw the uppercut, but it wasn't there. And he kind of stayed in the pocket a little too long and I caught him, and then he tried to catch with the check left hook, and I caught him and go with the right hand. But, you know, Floyd showed that he's, you know, a champion, especially at that time, a true champion, and he composed himself and started moving and slipping and sliding, and, you know, he did what he did, and, you know, he started pecking away and started pulling the fight in his way, and he won, man. He beat me.
By the way, I don't know if you knew this. We just called out Conor McGregor. He really wants to fight Conor. He said boxing or MMA.
He called out Mark Wahlberg, which is like a part of my management and stuff. I was like, man, fuck that. McGregor called out Mark Wahlberg to fight him. I don't know if it was fake or whatever, but I was like, man, fuck it. I'll fight you because I can do it in the boxing ring and I can do it in the octagon. I know a little jiu-jitsu and shit too. So I was like, fuck it. I think I'm the only champion in boxing right now that's willing to do that. Octagon.
Did he ever respond, Conor?
Hell no.
Nah, he didn't respond.
Conor beat the old man and shit. You saw that, right?
You remember when Conor said that he can beat anybody that Mayweather beat. He said he's gonna beat. And then I called him out too. I called Conor McGregor out too. I was like, okay, well, what's up?
Yeah, let's get down.
Let's do it. He wanted Mayweather, which I can, you know, I can see.
Shane once sparred Shaquille O'Neal. Yeah. How did you beat Shaq in sparring? Shaq's huge. 7'2", like 200 pounds.
Yeah, size
no matter. Size no matter. But we was having fun in there, man.
Shoves boxing.
Shaq is athlete. Shaq is really good. And I was surprised, actually, when he got on his toes and started jumping around and throwing a couple of jabs at me. The jabs were like, I mean, it was so far away. It's like, he was about like that far away. And the jab was reaching me, man. I was like, man, yeah. It's crazy. So, but I had a lot of fun with Shaq. And, you know, he's a great guy, man.
So if Shaquille O'Neal never stepped on a basketball court. But
if he was a boxer, he could have probably been a boxer.
He could have been big like Ali.
Yeah, I think that Shaquille has some good moves. Like, he can move really good.
But personality reminds me a lot of Ali.
The personality, the movement. He's an athlete. He's a true athlete, and he's a winner. He's a true winner. He wants to win.
Just think about what Kobe said about him. You saw that? Kobe said he would have won way more championships, like 10 championships, if Shaq wasn't so lazy. Saw that shit?
No, I don't believe that. Nah, come on, Kobe. I'm a Kobe fan too, but I don't believe that. I mean, Shaq is not lazy at all. Shaq, I mean, you can see him. He did the swimming. He did the boxing. I mean, he does everything. He did everything. Shaq versus, he did everything.
Yeah, he put a picture up of him. He was like, damn, I was so lazy. Shaq put a picture on Instagram. He literally dunked on the whole team.
The Nets. It was the New Jersey Nets.
Yeah.
He posterized five people. He was
like, I was so lazy.
Nah, Shaq wasn't lazy.
Dunked on five motherfuckers.
But you've done a lot of charity events with Shaq, right? Where you used to do back in the day?
Yeah, I remember. Charity events.
He's a good dude.
He's a great dude. Shaq is, he's like, you know, he's like, you first, like, be your best friend. Like, he's always having fun, joking around, laugh at the party, and just, you know, he's happy. You know, he's a happy person.
If Shaq was a boxer, would he have a record like Wilder, like 40-0?
Oh, man, Shaq, easily. I mean, he's 350 pounds. I mean, 300 pounds, and move like he moves, man, Shaq would be, he would have been a beast.
Maybe, is it too late for him? Can he still do it?
No, it's too late. It's
too late for Shaq?
Oh, you know, Shaq. We play basketball. Now, so you know he's fucking too late to box.
Yeah, it's too late. It's too late to box. But Shaq, man, he can do whatever he wants to do, and he's a great
guy. He's a DJ now.
DJ, like police officer.
I saw him on a slingshot. He goes on a slingshot ride.
Imagine getting fucking arrested by his big ass.
He's bringing you down.
But that's amazing. What was the best win of your career, if you consider, like?
Well, I think for the people and everybody and the mantra of the fight, it was with Oscar De La Hoya, the first one. But also, the Margarito fight was pretty good, too. At Staples, both of them at Staples Center. I sold out the Staples Center. It's never been as packed in the Staples Center as been Margarito.
I think you should get a statue there in front of the Staples Center.
I need a statue. Oscar got his statue. I need mine on the other side of the corner.
Well, they put a lot of basketball statues.
Tell him, hook that up, man. Put the fucking statue up, bro. Damn.
I proved I'm the king of California at that time. I was the king of California.